watching WDSU First Edition, your first live look at today's news and weather.
And a good morning to you. Got a little bit of cloud cover outside as we take a live look outside. This is our dome camera. Pretty picture. There's a Superdome all lit up in blue. Let's go to our Water Vapor satellite imagery. This is a cool picture, if you will. This gives us an idea of the amount of moisture in the mid and upper levels, and it's a great analytical tool because not only does it tell us about the moisture content, look at all these swirls it picks up. Big old dip in the jet stream. We have another little feature working right about here. This trough is dropping in. I'm going to pick this up, and then it's going to move across the map, and that's what's going to bring a cold front our way. Meanwhile, another cutoff flow is going to get established here. That was a cutoff flow. It's being picked up by this trough, but notice this southwesterly flow. That's going to keep on tossing some clouds our way, so we're going to be working in some high overcast through this afternoon out ahead of this cold front, which is currently developing right about here. This is going to move through, and that's going to give us a rain chance, maybe a few thunderstorms. And notice your temperatures this morning running about 15, maybe 20 degrees in certain spots, warmer compared to this time yesterday morning. 49 in Slidell, 54 in Hammond, got 56 around the Lakefront Airport, and 63 down around Grand Isle. So let's check out your exact cast headlines for your Monday. We're going to go warmer through tomorrow, rain, showers, and looking at the possibility of maybe a few thunderstorms by the time we hit Wednesday and Thursday. We are going to start bringing in some cooler temperatures, but again, for tomorrow, we're looking at some showers probably in the morning. A few of these thunderstorms might be strong. Not expecting any severe weather. Let me show you the forecast model. Notice your arrow. That's depicting the wind. All that moisture is going to start rising out of the south, and all of this, these are high clouds. They're going to be with us. Like I said, that southwesterly flow is pretty dominant. That will continue. May get a few sunny breaks from time to time, and by the time we get to the overnight hours tomorrow morning, there's your timestamp, 6:30. Look what happens. I don't think this is going to be any rain. We get maybe a few sprinkles. Could see some low clouds, maybe some fog. Your cold front is situated right here. We'll continue, move ahead in time. As you can see, it kind of gets a little frayed, but there it is. By 6 o'clock tomorrow evening, this front starts to push through. This could be maybe a couple of thunderstorms, mainly on the North Shore, Washington Parish, Pearl River County. That's going to start pushing through. And then by about Wednesday morning, 1 a.m., which is late tomorrow night into Wednesday morning, we finally start to clear out and get a bit of a break. Upper 60s, mid-70s for today. High overcast, maybe a little bit of sunshine. It is going to be a bit on the breezy side. Temperatures overnight will be rather mild, trending mainly in the 50s. A couple of spots might be in the lower 60s, mostly cloudy, and have a bit of a breeze. We keep that breeze going. We won't have as many fog issues. Let me show you what's happening as far as your 7-day exact cast is concerned. There it is right there. Mid-70s by tomorrow. 60% chance of rain, maybe a lingering shower Wednesday, then we clear it out Wednesday afternoon, get some sunshine in here for Wednesday afternoon, Thursday, then we cloud up again, looking at a slight chance of rain for Friday, and then back around the mid-70s for next Saturday and Sunday, and probably feeling a little humid. All right, there's your first edition. Look at weather. Rosa, back to you. And